when you're building, so gear up for LA. We have two. There is another one in North Hollywood called Project Steps. I don't have anything to do with that one. And then there is a Gear Up Project Grad and the YPI Gear Up Grant, which are not owned by the district. So the district gets no funds for them. They do a separate, it's kind of like they bring in the services. But I am a district employee, a proud former middle school teacher at the middle school, special ed. So Rebecca was like, hey, this is for you. So I just wanted to, Hanicia is on vacation this week. She took a few days, but she sent me with something, of course. And Hanicia is my better half. So this is a map of Cal State, or of UCLA. For those of you who are going to the CAPA program, we have, I've written at the top that you are to park in lot 4 and meet Hanicia in the Bruin Plaza by the Bear. I wrote that on there because if you're anything like me, you're like, yeah, whatever, I'll figure it out when I get there, and then you have no clue. So if you will take one and pass it down. She also asked me to give you her cell phone number, but that was after I printed them on Friday, so I think, does everybody have her cell phone, or does anybody need her cell phone?
I can just post it in the Google thing if you just give it to me.
Sure. I would, if it were me, I would take a picture of this sucker and write it down.
I can remind it up.
Because that's how I work.
But, watch, wait a minute. Watch.
Let's see.
Wait a minute. This is how cool.
Her cell is...
Wait a minute. Oops, okay. A second. I'm going to prove to you the awesomeness of mine.
Yeah, I don't even like Google Docs, but that's okay. I think I once deleted all of ISIS Google Docs. They gave me a privilege to like look at them, and then I was like, oh, there's some of my things and some of their things. So I just deleted them. I had to go.
What's your phone number?
323-810-0918. So now that's Lucia. So that's just that logistical piece. I know some of you are going, so we're really excited. The kids are pumped. Yes.
What about parking?
Here.
So parking is in parking lot 4. It's on the map. So what happens is on Friday morning around 7 a.m., buses will gather outside of the Gear Up High School, and they will take students, sleepy students, with all of their gear to UCLA for the weekend. And Hugo Cristales will be there. He's kind of leading it all. Erica will also be working. And, yes, and, yeah, Marisela. And so you will guys will, the kids get off the bus, and basically, you know, they're just worked until like 11 o'clock. They go to different sessions. So they go there, and I haven't seen the agenda for this time, but it's basically, you know, they go into a variety of rooms and they get information. So you will be in the room, kind of either listening to the adult, kind of getting it for yourself, or supporting if you can in the room. And then there's, you know, they always get a campus tour. They're going to get checked into their dorms on Friday because they do spend the night there. They eat lunch in the cafeteria, and really I think your role is more of an observer to see kind of the way that this particular group works effectively with getting students to understand their career paths, to develop their resume, to understand the connections between college and career. So comfortable shoes, you know, layers because it'll get cool and hot depending on when you're there, that type of a thing. Does that answer your question? Mm-hmm. Yeah. So you're not sitting at all. You'll probably be exhausted. You'll be traipsing around the campus with the kids. But it's very fun, and the kids are so much energy. We took 6 kids and their parents to San Francisco this past weekend for the Gear Up conference, and many of those kids are also going to the UCLA weekend, and they're very pumped and ready. And just being around the kids who are interested, it's really quite energizing. So that's really my operational piece. I also received an email from Rebecca asking if we would come talk about college visits.
I'm really just, I mean, because they've been taking kids on a lot of college visits, and I thought you could talk about in your mind what makes for a really good way to introduce kids to a college.
Well, I mean, I think, how many of you have been responsible for taking kids to a college on a tour? Yeah. And I think that we can all agree that, you know, the traditional, hi, so-and-so college, could you give us a tour, is not the best way. I think one of the most successful tours I've ever given and taken a group of kids to was on a Thursday night. I was getting everything ready for my trip to Cal Poly Pomona, and I wasn't sure where the bus should park, and so, I don't know if you remember the story, so I called the office and said, where does our bus park? And I'm looking at the map, and they're telling me things that are not on this map. And I realized I had booked my tour at Cal Poly San Luis Obispo.
Oh.
And there was no way I was getting kids the next morning. And so what I did was, like, you know, after I panicked, I downloaded a scavenger hunt I found online, and we did that with the kids. It was also Rush Week, which was amazing because they got to see all the different clubs and the activities going on the campus. So it turned out to be, and then I contacted my friends at Franklin High School who have a big Cal Poly Pomona engineering group, Latino students who do that. So they came out and had lunch with us. So it was one of the most successful trips, and the campus didn't even actually know we were on campus because we never went through their official channels. You know, I mean, I happen to know that the restaurant business at Cal Poly is also an excellent department, so we work through the department rather than the general campus tours. I think that's another good tip if you're going to go somewhere. I mean, in LA Unified, you can get a school bus for like $300, $400, and I know that that funding is hard. I don't know how likely you are to get a bus. You know, Target does the bus grants, so you can get a bus that way, and there's a couple of other places. But, you know, you just can take a kid to the campus to be immersed in the experience. We have a partnership with Occidental College, where every year is a little bit of a different kind of a trip. So when they're in junior and senior year, they go to the campus and they depart the bus and they leave with a college student. And now they leave with two because of some issues. But so they basically are spending the day doing whatever the college student does. So if college student works at the library, they're shadowing them at the library. Then they go to lunch. Then they go to this class. Another benefit is, depending on where you went to school, and you might have a connection with a professor, like if they can talk to your kids and your kids can sit in the class, that would be really helpful. Institutions like, fraternities are really great. We work with a group of fraternities, so if you happen to have been big in a fraternity or sorority in your college, maybe there's a chapter that you can reach out to. We had a lovely group of girls do a panel for us at Cal State Long Beach that really spoke to the kids. So I think more so, you know, our kids don't, the things that we get, especially the middle school kids, I remember back in the day, like, Miss, why aren't there any bells? Where are the fences? Who tells you when to go to sleep? You know, all of these things, they're coming, and, you know, when they haven't been exposed to tours, that's their perspective. And so I think just allowing them to understand the process of college and see it for themselves is transformational. We do college road trips where we take the kids up. The most we've ever done is two nights up to Northern California, and they get to see the campus. You know, we always try and get somebody to talk to them about financial aid, because when a kid can talk to another kid about getting financial aid and kind of that process, it's much less, it's more palatable than hearing maybe a financial aid officer talk about it. So that's another thing. I think the power of having kids do, you know, connecting with those high schools, or sorry, college students is really powerful. The only other thing is that, you know, Gear Up, and just my philosophy and everybody who works for the grant, is that, you know, we need to expose the kids to as many things as possible. So, you know, taking them to college, we take them to LACC, they practically could give you a tour of LACC because they've been there so many times. But there's different divisions, or there's different departments, or there's different things that they might do on a campus. But as they get older, one of the things we did, and we're talking about doing it again this year, is taking them very specifically in senior year tied to where their GPAs make them the most competitive. So a lot of our kids are getting into the UC Merced, for example. It's taking our kids. They're giving good financial aid packages. We have a bunch of them going. So our idea was to maybe this year we have a group of seniors, and we were thinking about really being targeted about those 3.3 kids, GPAs, who are eligible for a UC, and taking them by the busload to Merced, and just saying, like, this is Merced. This is a very likely school for you. Let's talk to some kids who are going there that are from LA Unified,
yeah.
And just, you know, making that connection for them.
So we were lucky. We got the Southern rep of Merced to talk to us, and he was willing to host any of them.
That would be, yeah.
So I still think you need to figure out a way, all of you, to get up there. Remember, if you go this Saturday, they can put you up in the dorm, but not during the school year. But you need to get to that. They're doubling in size in the next 5 years.
Wow.
They're going to double the size of freshmen. So.
I mean, we just were Googling it. It's like a 4 or 5 hour drive.
Yeah.
So it has to be an overnight trip, which is hard. Because then you get into the logistics of LA Unified and risk management. If you ever need any help with risk management, I know all the ways around them. You are welcome to contact me. Because they are a pain to deal with.
But if they know in advance what to do, it's better than figuring it out.
Yeah, LA Unified's risk management office has become kind of an odd duck, but I will say no more. I mean, just if you do, like if you don't hear back from them or you can't get something done, just feel free, really, to give me a call because it is all about who you know, and I sit in the building, so I am frequently going up to them and saying, hi, did you get my paperwork? Could we do this? Could we do that? And they're, you know, they like to push back because they're, I like to say they're averse to risk and they don't want to let you do anything. Sorry, that was a little bit of a, but you could clearly see my passion for that group. Yes, sir.
How do we contact you?
Oh, so I'm, my email is M as in Mary, J
as I'll send it out to you. It's a long email. I'm going
to
remind
you. Well, they're used to LA Unified emails.
Okay,
it's three initials, MJV. It's for Micaela Jeanette Vasquez, 1705, the last four of my employee at LA Unified.
Now, is that how they do it?
Yeah, that is how they used
I
to
never
do it.
How
they
work. That's my thought. It's very hard to find. It's very hard to do a Outlook search for somebody from LEOC because you can't like.
Yeah. When I got married and added Han, I actually did the right thing. I went in through Global. I added the Han, but people still can't find me. And I'm on the 11th floor of the Beaudry Building. Just wander around, and if you're ever there for a training, come see our space because there's about 7 or 8 of us there who work for the Gear Grant downtown.
So tell me, what's going on with the Gear Up grant? Where are you in it, and what's the progress?
So right now, I'm going to speak as if school had started. So all of the 9th and 10th graders at West Adams, Bernstein, STEM at Bernstein, and all 5 RFK schools are Gear Up students.
Okay.
At the school sites, we have a full-time counselor, we have a full-time coordinator, we have 2 community reps, and we have a mentoring coordinator slash program assistant. That's what we have at our senior schools because, and that's only 1 grade level. We also have freshmen, college freshmen. So this is the first time that Gear Up grants are allowed to follow students into the first year of college. And I will tell you that this summer has been so intense because we're working around the idea of summer melt. I'm not sure how much you guys have read about that, but it has been, I mean, I don't know how to present this data to kind of Carol and her group and kind of the district and Ms. King or Dr. King, because it is a crime that college counselors are not on the school site during the summer.
Yes, he's been going in on Fridays to have office hours, and he's been dealing with all kinds of crimes.
I mean, I will tell you that we have had at a Cal State, a student receive a letter. She was in Summer Bridge here at Cal State LA, sitting in her class, when she received a phone call from Cal State LA telling her that they were rescinding her enrollment in the fall. And the reason why is because she had not taken, one of the students had a problem in that she had not taken the EAP, or the math placement, or the English placement test, and she said, but I am exempt from that. I passed the classes. My counselor told me I was exempt. And they said, oh, well, we don't get to see that information from the state, so we didn't know that. You didn't attempt to register, so we're sorry, you're out of luck. So we had to call kind of, we went through multiple layers, and we were able to rescind it, but that was because, like, we happened to know the chancellor's office at this CSU. Because this was taken high up in the school, and they were like, no. Because what we've heard over and over again is that students, that they are so impacted, that really they're just looking to cut.
That's what I was told.
They're just looking to cut.
So you don't jump
through that hoop, there's nothing left for it.
So we had a counselor, remember Allison, who was here last week, and she had to go, her student had been rescinded.
Yeah.
She went over there, and they rescinded the rescinding.
Oh.
So they're rescinding the rescinding, but you have to have an adult grown-up go and help them fight. They're not being able to do it on their own.
And this was one of our counselors who's working. She was kind of denied also, and then she just kept pushing, and we took it higher. But, you know, no student, first of all, our first-gen kids don't necessarily even know that they've made the right decision. They're questioning themselves, and I'm sure, you know, a lot of times there's pressure from family to go to the community college or to do this or to not go or whatever. So they don't need this knock to their psyche of having to fight. I mean, we had a kid who had walked across the stage at a high school and was told by the college that she didn't graduate high school. And it had to do with an issue with the counselor 2 years ago. But, you know, She called us because she happens to know us. We've been with her for 6 years. But when the school sites don't provide the counselor during the summer, it's hard. I know that Local District Central has the gear up off, or the counseling coordinator there, Carmella, is there, and she can run a transcript maybe. But here's another crazy thing. Like, and this is where it's systems issues that are failing the kids. LACC says that they do not, and maybe some of you know this. How have you helped kids get their transcripts to LACC before you left on vacation?
We send the college ones.
You just emailed, or you?
I mailed.
You mailed, right? So it's so funny because we have about 4 kids at LACC who have been told that they can't accept paper transcripts. That LACC is a campus that is paper-free, no longer accepts them. Right? Well, I said, how are most kids getting there? Because clearly, so they got there somewhere. They said, we accept them via email. And we said, well, we're all unified. We can't email transcripts. That's, we'd lose our credential. And so it was kind of a strange impasse because kids legitimately had their, they couldn't do it. Yes?
So what we were doing is I would physically print out, and then we would go to the scanner, and mm-hmm. they themselves, the students, can email their own transcripts.
Right.
So they would scan their transcript, and then they themselves, under their email, would email the office.
Why would you need to bring your transcript to LACC?
In case something had changed or was a final official transcript.
But when you're going to community college, you
right.
don't need to show them.
I've had to do that. It was a qualifier for the 1 year.
Is that what it is? Is this a qualifier for the LA Promise?
Yeah.
Right. So new layers of challenges, because they've never had to do this.
Don't you have to be 18? Like, if you're under 18?
No, absolutely not. You don't have to do anything. All you have to do is take your placement test and register and you're a student.
So, I think it's a lot of things that are not necessarily complicated. They're just, you can see where there's problems in the system and that's really where we're facing.
It also sounds like to me that the systems aren't catching up to change.
Correct. So it's interesting because the LACC rep said, well, how are you working with Cal State LA? Because they're not accepting paper transcripts either. They're only online. And we said, clearly we found the old school person at Cal State LA and at LACC was taking the paper because that's who we've been working with. So it's, I think one of the issues that we are trying to work on at the district level is talking about these issues with, Superintendent Martinez
mm-hmm.
or kind of the higher powers so that they can bring the pressure. I mean, we have Go Central City in our local district, right? It's a partnership between Cal State LA and LACC. So I feel we have a meeting next week scheduled with the president, and I want to say, what kind of a partnership is this? Like, these are the issues that you have with our students. Let's leverage, you should at least be nice to our kids. We're from Central, and we have this agreement. It's just kind of a weird adult. Oh, I'm being filmed.
That's all right. Just for the class. This is not available to anybody else.
But I think that, the college visits, I have a funny story. I don't know how much you know about Gear Up. It's a hard concept to wrap your head around because, if you know Upward Bound, right, they pick X amount of kids that meet a certain requirement and they work with them. Gear Up really takes anybody in the grade level. It goes from special ed student to highly gifted, and we move the whole class, or at least we try. And so we also get to work with parents, and we get to work with teachers. So we're kind of hard to pin down and understand because teachers who have, tutors in their classroom, because we help with academics, say, oh, you're a tutoring program. People who have peer mentors say, oh, you're a peer mentoring program. Teachers where we always take your kids out of class say, oh, you're a college visit program. And we're not. We're really kind of all of those things, because the goal is to move the needle in the community and understanding college access. But so I think that's an interesting role that our grant plays in the district, is because we're trying to make sure that it can seed the change in more than just the Gear Up schools.
I think a lot. I had a rep from Bennington and a rep from Dickinson come and talk to us.
Mm-hmm.
The other thing that they're advocating, and I have Linda McGee coming, who she gets on every college campus in this country. So we're going to try to get them. They can use summers to go travel for free, and then.
Yeah, I know that in Local District Central, there is a desire to host a giant college fair at LACC with a lot of different reps coming. I think
Felice is on the she's not there. Felice helps do the one in South LA, so if you ever want to talk to her, she has all the organizational materials. And and she'll be back. She arranges all the college visits.
I did have a principal tell me once, no thank you, I'm not interested in having gear up at my school because we already do college visits. And I was like, oh, you just have no idea. Because, you know, I'm pretty proud of our visits in general because we try to not just call the office and say, could you give us a tour? Even if it's reaching out to a particular department, a restaurant like at Cal Poly, like I said, they would only take 30 kids, so we had to find something different for the other 30, and it's a little more work. But it is well worth it when you have a kid, you know, walk onto Channel Islands who they've been, you know, thinking that they hate it, and all of a sudden they're there, and they're like, oh, this is it. You know, that is the moment when they have something to work for that it all becomes very real. So, I highly encourage you. You can't have enough. And then if you can take the parents, it's even better.
See?
How are you, I know that you're talking about how that you're following your students into college.
Mm-hmm.
How are you guys supporting them while they're at college?
So it's been a challenge. We, through the district, there's a lot of issues dealing with the district. That camera is very... and we were required to put out a request for proposal. We have money to give the college campuses to support our kids.
Yeah.
Really, our thought was to hire somebody from the college who knew the college, who could then say, call in all of your students, come to lunch, or do this, or do that, kind of act as that intermediary, because we don't know the colleges. And so that was our thought. And we knew from based on the data of our schools that like 100 went to Cal State LA. And 50 went to Santa Monica, and so and so and so. We knew the schools where our students went. So we wanted to reach out to those schools and say, you know, what if we gave you $400 a kid? Could you work with our students? And then also input data, you know, track all of that information and report back to us. And we had to actually issue a formal request for proposals to every single Cal State, every single community college, and every single UC, even if our kids had no track record of going there. And it was a, like, 40-page document that was a week to turn around, colleges could fill out. The only campus that said yes, they were interested in receiving money, was Cal State LA.
And
that was
that
because the office said no, but we had a connection through Rebecca and her dean, who was like, yeah, this is my passion, I'll do this. So here, we have now 225 kids coming here. So we have somebody paid through the grant to, her name is Wendy, and she basically either sits at the Beaudry building calling kids and checking in on them, emailing them, or she comes to the campus. And so that's really our model for the schools where we have more kids. So we want to have, at this point we've hired our own people, first year advisors we're calling them, and they are being deployed to the campuses, and they're working in the Beaudry building to make, you know, connections with kids.
Bianca Guzman's coming to talk.
Oh, so that's the one who has our kids here. She's kind of was like,
she's gonna have a
big, you know, I've never met her, I've only spoken to her, but she seems like a big mama bear that's like, yeah, come on, we'll all be fine, let's go together, you know.
She's an awesome human being,
yeah.
And she's coming in to meet us this week.
So, but there have been, you know, the summer melt issues, we have a lot of kids who are melting, who are not going to Cal State LA anymore, and who were trying to work into LACC. And there's, you know, what's interesting is we just kind of had this big aha moment. Kids have got to change their whole financial aid, like where they're going. They have to report it out. So we have, that's our next step, is to tell all the kids who are no longer going where they SRI to, you know, about how they need to change that.
Why are they not going?
I mean, it's a variety of reasons. Many of them have been caught by the gotcha system. You know, you didn't do this, you didn't do that, you didn't register. Wendy actually, here's the thing about the colleges, is they're not as proactive. Like, we had 50 kids who had not registered for their orientation. If you don't go to orientation, you cannot come to the college.
That's right.
And it was the Thursday before the Friday deadline at 5. And it was like 50 kids. So what we did was everybody panicked. Everybody took 10 kids. And we tried during those few hours to make phone calls to them. And some of them said, I'm in my orientation right now. What are you talking about? Because Cal State LA doesn't update their system very often. Some of them legitimately hadn't done it. And so, but it's these kinds of things that then the kid gets a letter home that says, you know, you're out. And they believe it. They are not necessarily able or understand how much you can advocate and fight to. I've had a refrigerator break twice. My husband can advocate till the cows come home and he can escalate, you know, but our kids don't necessarily have that ability to fight for themselves. And so I think that onus is on us as when we prepare them for college. So, you know, some of them, the reality is the financial ages isn't. We had one girl who thinks she was going to drive to Channel Islands every day.
Oh,
like, sure, you could do that for a month, maybe. And then you're going to be melted, and then where will you be? So it's also these conversations. We saw an amazing person, Sarah Goldlick Robb. She's all about reforming financial aid. And I will send you the book because I can't, well, actually, it's on hold for me at the public library. But she did an amazing job about how the FAFSA system is failing and some interesting things about how our kids are not making it even with the financial aid, even with the Pell Grant. You know, Pell Grant was designed 30 years ago or so to help kids. They're not today's kids. And the percent of kids that we have who are homeless, who are going to college, who are living in their car to make the college the reality. So it's a fascinating.
What's her name?
It's in my Amazon card, I'll tell you.
That's great.
We heard an amazing speaker. I don't know if you guys have ever heard of, I'll get it wrong, Hill Harper or Harper Hill, I can't remember. He's one of the people, sexy people of the year. It's true. But he's also really into advocating, and he's working with Baltimore schools, right? He wrote Letters from a Young Brother, and it's a memoir of students who are like writing in to talk about their experiences with becoming college ready and kind of coming around to the realization that they are worth it. And we're reading it as a staff this year. It's really quite powerful.
What's the name of this?
It's Hill Harper or Harper Hill. And
he's the actor.
He's the actor.
So it's Hill Harper.
Yeah. Clearly, I don't watch.
I do.
I wish I could. With three kids, you know. The financial aid book that I'm talking about is a bit of a read. I mean, it's a lift because it's pretty serious, but I think it's pretty amazing. It's called Paying the Price: College Costs, Financial Aid, and the Betrayal of the American Dream.
There you go.
And it's
the Betrayal of the American Dream. There you go. That's a light summary entry.
I know. It's yellow. It's bright.
It's yellow and bright. Uh-huh. That's the way they can sell it.
There is a companion book to the brother, Letters from a Brother. There's Letters from a Sister. And so I have not read that one. I don't know what it's like, but I imagine it's very similar.
I know there's an expert on college access for African American young men who wrote this amazing book. And he just came to UCLA. Or USC. UCLA. He was at Penn, and he came here. So I'm imagining a lot of work going to go on to support more kids in the LA Basin because of him coming to LA.
There's a really, I can't go, but some of our folks are going. It's from the EdTrust West, which I don't know if you've ever been on the EdTrust West website, but it has a lot of good information for us. And there's a conference in San Diego.
Yeah, NCAN.
No, it's right after NCAN, so NCAN ends Wednesday.
Okay.
This starts Thursday afternoon, and it's addressing the issues of young men of color and kind of how we can work with that because it's an issue for our group.
We had an amazing speaker last week, Chris Monroy. He graduated from Fremont High School and went to Pomona and is now an admissions officer there.
Oh.
Who was talking about the issues of young men of color and college grit.
Have you ever, do you know Roberto from Scripps? Mm-hmm. He would love, he's always really great to come. He's a good speaker and he has a great story and he's, did you ever meet him?
There's a man at
Scripps.
Well, they do. By the way, Scripps has a great, it's a women's college in Claremont, McKenna, and they have a two-summer program for girls starting in 10th grade to get them ready for college. But they have to apply to be part of the Scripps Academy. So if you ever have like a really amazing girl that you think needs to have that mentoring.
So he's in charge of that program?
Yep.
Scripps
Academy.
Yeah.
Yep, it's part of like just knowing where we have to have.
Well, the question is, how is we as like 35 people sitting in a room who are all interested in this, kind of share resources? I mean, I don't know whether you can find 50 kids from your campus who would be interested in going to UC Merced, but if you could find 5, and you could find 7, and you could find, you know, so on and so on, is there a way to pool together our resources? Which is what we did. You know, there's not a lot of college recruiters who will come to schools like weekend was we brought out a Dartmouth recruiter and a couple of other ones, but they talked to all of our schools. Like, we did a whole Belmont Zone of Choice night so that people could come here from this. So it's oftentimes your neighbor across the street or your high school down the road that how could you work together to share resources.
Well, it's the same thing with these private colleges. They're part of a consortium now.
Mm-hmm.
If you give them the date, they'll send one person out. You just don't know which college it's going to be.
Right.
So,
I mean, there's also, you know, I'm not a recruiter from the college is fine, but sometimes it's more interesting to talk to somebody who's local. So a lot of our private colleges have local alumni. You know,
they gotta hear whoever will come.
Yeah, I mean, we have a connection through somebody who works on the superintendent's floor went to LMU. So he's like, I can get you somebody from LMU, sure, you know. So it's all about those connections.
We had a senior from Pittsburgh here last week, and she was telling us. I mean,
right.
They like talking about it. It's just a matter of all the school sites at Mark's site are going to have to work together. All the sites at Kelly's site are going to have to work together because they're not going to just come out to a small pilot school. You're going to have to get the whole school to offer and some information.
Did I hear you right? You were saying Target will fund a bus?
Yes.
Target has a, yeah, you can write and they'll give you a bus.
They will still be able to.
It's
very small of a microgram.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
It's for buses.
Or you can hold like a tamale sale and raise enough funds probably in a couple afternoons. Like for the Student Body Association would do that. I mean, a bus is not super expensive through the district, and so, you know, from 9 to 2, you can have a nice trip to some place close by.
So it's called a field trip grant.
Yeah, I can't remember.
Oh, there you go.
And counselors can avail themselves of this, but you still need to partner with the teacher.
If you have a good relationship with your board member, they have funds to do buses. Don't tell me I told you that. And also city council members. They are supposed to give money for this type of thing. And so oftentimes you need to just ask, and it's not a hard ask.
Really? The city council as opposed to the school board member? It's the city council?
They both have funds, but the city council is supposed to be giving, like they have money directly for kind of supporting their local community. So,
has anybody here ever spoken to your city council person?
Yeah,
have you gotten money?
Bus,
what do they
yeah.
pay for?
Huh?
What do they pay for?
Say that again?
What do they pay for?
Just one bus.
One bus?
Yeah. That was it. I mean, but it's better than
one bus is better than another.
$700 out of our pocket.
That's right.
Yeah.
It's a great one also to take them to the cash for college.
Well, the cash for college will usually give you those for free.
One bus.
One
yeah.
bus. But if you need another bus, you want to bring two buses.
And you have to do it early.
You have to do it early or else I'm like, oh, we're done.
So do you know that cash for college was at the convention center for how many years?
And now they're
a
at
a ton.
And they lost
the
contract.
Well, but wait. The funny part is that cash for college, the convention center, was not on the risk management approval list.
Huh. Is that why they're not there?
No, because I got it on there. Because I was like, all of you guys can take your, you know, you're at a school site. People will forgive you if, like, oh, I didn't know or whatever. But, you know, I'm, like, there in the voting building. If I mess up, I, you know. So I had to make sure that it was approved. So there I am. And their risk management was like, well, you know, we have this school. I talked to somebody from this school. And she's like, no, we're just going. We don't really need to pay attention. And I was like, ugh. So you're welcome. And now they're not there.
But you're fair enough to see.
And they're Alley Trade Tech.
But they're not the same anymore. So.
What did they move to? I'm sorry.
LA Trade Tech.
Okay.
And they're going to be the second week of October. They're much earlier this year. So you're going to need to apply for your buses now.
Well,
rather than being in November, they're now October 10th.
They just
I just got it last week.
No.
Yeah.
What just came out?
The email invitation to college.
Yeah.
But I think just if I can end with the reason why I'm really excited that there's a bunch of different types of people in this room is because I can imagine that it's hard to be a college counselor on a campus and where people think it's your job. Or if it's a pilot where it's supposed to be everybody's job and in reality it's easier to, oh, I've got to get this done and, you know, kind of put something like a field trip aside because it's not right as pressing as it is. So I really believe in the power of like the community and coming together, and the network that you guys have created is, I'm hopeful, you know, you can call Sean and say, you know, hey, help me with this idea, or, you know, how can we do do this and reach out to the teachers at your school site, because you know, just like the kids always take it better from their peers, teachers always take it better from their peers. And so if you can just speak to the power of kind of talking to kids about this,